Welcome to Enots Engineering, I'm Alan. In today's video, we're checking how to measure backlash on your cross slide and what you need to do to reduce it. So let's go into the workshop and see how we do it. Today we're looking at backlash on the lathe. So what is backlash and how do you measure it? Well, first of all, we'll start with the cross slide. If I pull it backwards and forwards, you can hear that play. So we need to measure that to see exactly how much play there is. What I'm doing is just placing a piece of bar in the chuck jaws so I can put a dial indicator against it. So I'll just hold a dial indicator in the tool post, lock that up, move it across so it's touching. Let's move that to zero. Just zero that there. I've pushed the slide away from me. Now if I pull the slide towards me without turning the handle, 20 thou. That is backlash, or free movement in the slide against the thread, or play in the nut and the thread. If you have a digital readout attached to your machine, you can also use that to check it. Let me show you how to do that. This is my readout. I've zeroed it. Now if I move the slide in, now you can see on there it's showing me 40 thou movement. That's double than I had on my dial indicator. And the reason for that is I've got my cross slide reading doubled. Because if you take a thou cut or a 10 thou cut, you're actually taking 20 thou off diameter. So that is giving me an idea of the diameter. But the backlash, if you halve that, 20 thou again. So what is backlash? Well, backlash is the movement between the nut and the screw on the top slide in this case. In my case, it's 20 thou. You can see that moves in and out. For most jobs, you could still get away with that backlash. But the danger comes when you're using a very narrow tool, like a parting off tool. You're parting a part off, and if your tool is just set just under the centre line, the part could pull the tool under the part, which pulls it in. So if you're back here and you haven't taken the backlash out, it is possible that the tool could pull and move it in and take a 20 thou cut. So let me remove the tool holder and we'll have a look what we need to do to fix it. To remove the cross slide screw, just undo two cap heads that are at the end, the other one on this side. And you should be able to unwind the screw. What I'm doing is unwinding it off the nut inside. And this is a left hand thread. The next job is to slacken off this screw here, which is in the end of the nut. So what you need to do is push the slide backwards and then you can get the nut out underneath at the end. I find that the hole that's in the bottom of the cross slide is not big enough. Even the original nut wouldn't fit through that. This is the nut, the original nut off that Boxford. You can see it has a diameter, a screw in the end, a hole on the side there. This hole is when you tighten that screw in, it pushes a pin out of that hole and grips this on the top slide. When it was made, the casting wasn't centre, and they've just about got away with that thread in there. But this was the original one that was on the Boxford from new, and I changed that 8 years ago. The lathe's now over 50 years old. When I changed it, I made a video. It's on YouTube. I'll leave a link to that video because it shows how I made this part, which is the replacement, exactly the same, hole in the end. And this time the thread is a bit more centralised. The only difference between the two is the length. It's about an eighth of an inch narrower. The reason why I did that was I bought this as a bar of phosphor bronze, and to go up bigger costs a lot more money, and I'd only waste most of it. So I made two, and this is the second one. The first one has been in for 8 years, and I've done more work on the lathe in the last 8 years than I did in the previous 40 years. Let's fit the new pin in the hole just below the surface, and the grub screw in the end. And what happens when that grub screw goes down? It pushes that pin out and locks it. So I can put this back into the cross slide, pull the top slide back across to the middle, feed in the screw, that's feeding through. Also, it's a bit tighter because it's a new nut. You may find the end of the screw is not worn, so it's tight. Replace the tube screws. And that's the new one fitted. Okay, I've reassembled it. Now we'll see how much backlash I have in this one. Now the problem I have with this is the cross slide thread on this is the original, and I know it's worn in the middle but not at the end where you never use it, and not at this end. So I'll set this in the middle of the thread. That's a zero. Push it forward. Fourth thou. Now if I look at my direct readout, set my tool post to zero. Zero it on there. Push it forward. And that's saying nearly eight thou. But don't forget I have that on double measurement, so that's 4 thou. So I've gone from, I think it was 20 thou down to 4 thou. Well, that should last me another 8 years. Oh well, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. Hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.